Vitabiotics Well Woman sponsors Countdown.
And welcome back to the Countdown studio. Here we are Wednesday and we're halfway through the half term. And the world's a better place for it. Why? Less cars on the road because the school run is still suspended. Fewer cars, less road rage. Rachel, you're not a road rage woman, are you?
Not normally, because I'm never normally up in rush hour, or for the first one, obviously, but I do get slightly angry when I get stuck behind tractor drivers on narrow roads.
Tractor drivers?
Yes.
You leave us alone. You leave tractors out of this.
Oh, come on. What's the top speed on a tractor? I've never seen one go more than about 5 miles an hour on the roads.
That's about right. That's about right. Personally, I never take my tractor onto the road where it can be tutored at by vulgar cars. We stay in the country, in the field where we belong.
Yeah, too right. I wish everybody else who had a tractor would as well.
Yeah, but the thing is that if you are trailing a tractor, just look at the geometry and the mechanics of it. You can see that PTO spinning, you can see the suspension going up and down, and in fact we've got some people from the Royal Agricultural College in Cirencester here today and they'll know all about it. So, a little cheer from the Royal Agricultural College, please, for the tractor drivers of the world. Yay! Thank you.
Wow,
thank
you
very
enthusiastic.
Much. How about that? Now, who have we got sitting over here? We've got two Chrises. We've got Chris the Champ, Chris Rose, a school teacher from Shackleford in Surrey, learning Mandarin so that he can commentate during ping pong because he also teaches sport and geography. And our challenger today is Chris Butler. A trainee maths teacher from Oldham who's recently returned from a three-year round-the-world trip.
Yeah, I went round to see South America and Australia and Asia, but in the end, I had to come back to England because I missed Countdown too much.
How much did we pay you to say that? Get yourself into trouble at all?
I tried to keep out of trouble, at least that's what I better say because my mum's watching at home. I'll tell you later about it.
Yeah, I'm surprised if you didn't because from what I understand, you played on stage with the rock star bad boy, oh. Pete Doherty of the Libertines. I thought he could have led anybody astray, that one.
I tried not to.
No, well, well done. Well done.
No, that was in Oldham. It wasn't the other side of the world.
And you've got something in common with Rachel. She's a big cat woman. She's got a cat called Beastie, apparently. Weighs 14 stone. But you
pretty much
have got a cat called Chairman Meow.
That's correct, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And?
It's not as fat as that, it's a kitten at the moment, so it's getting into mischief.
Good. Excellent. Well, a round of applause for our contestants today. And over in Dictionary Corner again, of course, Susie Dent, and a wonderful woman who started, I think, as a singer aged 7 and has turned into one of Britain's truly great broadcasters.
Thank you.
That's Gloria Hannaford.
Thank you very much. Today, I'll sing.
All right.
Take it as a threat.
Well, I look forward to that. So, Chris Champ Rose, I'm going to call you Champ, actually, because
good.
We've got a challenger called Chris as well. Off you go, it's a letters game.
Hello, Rachel.
Hi, Chris.
Consonant, please.
Thank you. Start today with S.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
L.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
M.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
F.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, B.
We take it away.
Thank you.
So, champ?
Seven.
A seven. And Chris?
Seven.
Both seven. Chris, the champ?
Beliefs.
Beliefs. Chris?
Mobiles.
Mobiles. Are you happy over there, Gloria?
Very happy. Yes, as they said in unison. Because on my pad I have beliefs and mobiles, so I was in tune with you.
Yeah.
Well done. Is there a foibles there somewhere?
Foibles, very good. Weaknesses.
Foibles,
another
yeah.
Seven.
Of which I know a great deal. So, seven all, and Chris, our challenger. Off you go.
Hello, Rachel.
Hi, Chris.
Could I start with a consonant, please?
Thank you. Start with S.
And a vowel?
A.
And a consonant?
C.
And another consonant?
F.
A vowel, please?
O.
And a consonant?
H.
Another consonant?
J.
A vowel?
A.
And finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with I.
And it's the countdown clock. So, challenger Chris?
Six.
A six. And the champ?
I've only got a four.
Four?
Fish.
Fish. Chris?
Fascias.
Fascias. All right.
How are you spelling that, Chris?
F-A-C-I-A-S.
Yeah, you can actually have that. It's an alternative spelling of the more usual fascia, like of a mobile phone or a door frame, F-A-S-C-I-A, but there is an alternative spelling without that first S, so that's absolutely fine.
And in the corner, what have we got? Anything else?
No, I just had fascia singular in that sense,
Kales was there for five, or oafish is another six.
Oafish. Whenever I look at Rachel, I feel a bit oafish. Chris, the champ. It's a letters game. Off you go.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Chris. N.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
R.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
Y.
And a consonant.
L.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
D.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. U.
And off we go. Yes, champ?
Six.
Six. And Chris?
Seven.
Seven. The champ?
Loaned.
Loaned. And the challenger?
Got laundry.
Laundry.
Very nice. Very good.
That's good. That's very good.
We
Gloria.
Got an eight today.
Go on.
Which is underlay.
Underlay, as
You're
in carpet.
You're going to kick yourself now, Chris, as though you didn't see that.
Right, so our champs got some catching up to do. 7-20 with the challenger, and it's the challenger's turn for a letters game.
Okay, Rachel, I'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Chris. P.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
R.
And another.
G.
And a vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
L.
And a consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
A.
And finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with E.
Here we go. Tick tock. So, our challenger, Chris?
It's got a six.
A six. And the champ?
I'm going to try a seven.
All right. Chris?
Angler.
Angler. And the champ?
Gleaner.
A gleaner?
Gleaner, somebody who gleans.
Yeah.
Very famous painting called The Gleaners. I'm pretty sure that will be fine. In historical times, was to gather leftover grain after a harvest. I think that's what's depicted in the painting.
It's a great newspaper, I think, in the West Indies, isn't it? The Jamaica Gleaner.
Oh, OK.
It's one of the big national papers in the West Indies. Can you offer us anything more,
Gloria? Yeah, we can, actually. We can have plunger.
Yes.
Or general.
I think if you're a washer-up in Paris, you're called a plongeur, aren't you?
Yeah.
Same deal, same deal. So 14 to 20. You're 20, the challenger, well done. And we move swiftly into the first numbers game, and it's the champ's turn to crack it.
Two large ones, please, and four small ones.
Thank you, champ. Two large, four little ones. And for the first time today, the four small are three, five, another five, and four. And your two large, 50, and 75. And the target, 528.
528. So, champ?
I've got 530.
530?
I've got 528.
528. Well done. Let's hear that. Let's hear about that.
OK, 75 plus 50 plus 5.
125 plus 5, 130.
And times that by 4.
Times that by 4 for 520.
And then add on the 5 and 3.
And then the other 5 and the 3. Well done. 528.
Very good. I'd expect nothing less from a trainee math teacher, of course. And now it's our turn to sweep across to Gloria, who's done pretty much everything in television. What are you up to now, Gloria?
Well, of late we've been doing our Rip Off Britain series, which is about how people feel they're being ripped off. And, of course, in the last 12 months, everything seems to gear towards energy prices and banking in particular. But currently I'm doing a programme called Doorstep Crime 999. And it's how people are scammed on their own doorstep. And if you think about it, we've all got a front door and we're all open to a scam, whether we like to think of it or not. But it's quite remarkable, finding it very interesting, because one man, believe it or not, was scammed out of £520,000. And, again, it's too long to go into all the details, but a lot of the people who scam, a lot of the rogue traders, very charming, very plausible, very friendly. And this poor man, he'd lost his mum recently and he was living in a very beautiful five-bedroomed house. And, you know, this rogue trader came up and said, I'd like to treat your driveway, I'm in the area, he treated it with some stuff. And then he goes on to say, I think your house is subsiding because I've seen some evidence of it. And you see, you from the surface, you think, how can anybody be scammed out of that? And this man was handing over 30, 40, 50,000 pounds at a time, sometimes in cash. So you say to him, but John, why would you ever think that's the way to pay for a job? And he just goes, well, I mean, they convinced me that I needed all the big machinery and my house was going to fall down. But it's very sad because that man, you know, lost his house. He had to sell his house to pay the so-called debt. And because he was afraid of, they said they'd take him to the police. And now he's living in rented accommodation, you know, not very good rented accommodation. It's so sad. So it's a warning to all of us, you know, don't answer the door to anybody. And that's really the message, you know, unless you really know the person or they've made an appointment, don't let them in. Simple as that.
What a wicked thing to do.
Wicked. But it's also, and sadly, the most vulnerable people are scammed first and foremost, you know, it's really sad.
Yeah, yeah. And had the con man committed a criminal offence or had he just sort of...
Oh, well, now he's in prison, so he has
good.
Been caught. But then the analysis is that, I can't remember the exact figures, but let's say there were 8 people who'd been scammed, and in the end he only has so much money that he'll put into the court or can offer. Yeah. So it has to be shared out by 8 people, which means our case that lost, you know, 520,000 might only get 120,000 back. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's very sad all round. So be warned, folks. Don't open your door.
Yeah. We've all got to be a bit more suspicious.
I've
That's the truth of it.
Yeah.
That's the truth of it. Well, now it's time for a tea time teaser. And today's first tea time teaser is he can sup. And the clue, he can sup a lot more than his friends. Still, they've all got these. Welcome back, and the clue, he can sup a lot more than his friends. Still, they've all got these, and the answer is paunches. Paunches. And so it is that we move on to Chris, our challenger, who's ahead 30 to 14. Well done. It's a letters game. Off you go.
OK, I'll start with a consonant again, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Chris. R.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
L.
And another.
C.
And a vowel.
A.
And another.
O.
And a consonant.
S.
Another consonant.
G.
And I'll finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with E.
And away we go. Challenger Chris.
I will do a risky seven.
A risky seven. And the champ?
I'll go for a six then.
Go ahead.
Graces.
Graces. And our challenger?
I'll try scalia.
Scalia.
Yes, scalia is absolutely fine.
Can you offer us anything more?
Oh, well, I can go one better today. I'm pleased to say we've got an eight on calories.
Calories?
Yes. Something we all count.
I'm trying to cut down on my calories at the moment, actually. Well done. So 14 to 37, our challenger in the lead, and it's the champ's turn to try and redress that balance. It's a letters game, champ.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Chris. Z.
Thank you. Vowel, please.
I.
And a consonant.
B.
And a vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
R.
And a consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one, E.
It's the countdown clock. So, champ?
Six.
A six. And Chris, the challenger?
I'll try a seven.
All right, champ?
Brazen.
Brazen. Seems fair. Chris?
Tribune.
A tribune?
Yes.
That's
not
a good one.
At all. Very nice. Just write that one down.
Also on Susie's list. But Susie has another really good one, too.
Oh, yeah, there is an eight there. An urbanite is a city or a town dweller. An urbanite.
Very good. That's an excellent one.
An urbanite. So, our challenger, 44, to the champs, 14. And, Chris, our challenger. Off you go.
Hi, Rachel. I'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Chris. N.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
D.
Another consonant.
R.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel, please.
E.
Consonant.
M.
And finish with a vowel.
And finish with A.
And it's the clock. So, Chris, the challenger, what have you got for us?
I've got a six, but I've not written it down.
A six not written down, champ?
Six as well.
All right, let's have the unwritten down one.
Radiant.
And champ?
Craned.
Craned.
Yes, radiant, absolutely.
Anything else? Can you improve on that?
We can, we think. We get top marks today, don't we?
Just,
we have an eight.
Yes.
Sorry to tell you guys. Marinade.
A marinade.
Yeah, good one, yeah.
So, champ, you're drifting.
I am.
You are drifting, and I want to see a little bit of a sort of acceleration here. It's a letters game. Take it away.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
Says the tractor driver. Thank you, Chris. Start with O.
And a consonant.
D.
And a consonant.
V.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
T.
And a consonant.
G.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
D.
And a vowel, please.
And lastly, I.
Here we go. So, champ?
Just a five.
A five. And our challenger?
Five also.
All right. Champ?
Avoid.
Avoid. Like the plague and the challenger?
Digit.
Digit?
Yep.
Digit. Gloria, Susie.
And having boasted about our eights, I'm afraid I'm not doing very well at all, but you have a theory on this one, don't you?
Well, it's just a six, and not deliberately chosen to make Nick cross, because, Nick, you will absolutely hate this one. It's a vidiot.
Which is?
An avidiot, as you'll see there in America, is a habitual, undiscriminating watcher of TV or videotapes.
A vidiot.
Just to prove to you it isn't.
I don't know how these things creep in there. That's an Americanism, is it?
It is an Americanism, but remember, a lot of our slang is American, and in fact, many of American words used to be British ones and travelled over and then came back.
Oh, right. Well, they should have kept them. We exported. We didn't want them. That's why we sent them in there in the first place. Now they're sending them back. Too much, too much. Chris the champ, 25, the challenger, 55. And we now turn to Susie. You're on.
It does involve Americans again, I'm afraid. But in an interesting way, and on the surface, perhaps not as you would expect, because I'm going to talk about gung-ho, which is a Chinese term, and it does sound quite Chinese. But it involves a Lieutenant Colonel Evans F. Carlson, who was based out there with his squadron, and he greatly admired the spirit and the ethos of the Chinese Communist Organisation. And it was specifically a Chinese Industrial Cooperative Society that he admired so much. And the long name for that was shortened in Mandarin Chinese to Kung Ho. Two words, literally meaning work and harmony. Apologies for the accent there. But Carlson introduced them to his US Marine Corps battalion as an imperative, as a command, meaning work together, lads. So it's just strange that perhaps that one of the best-known Marine catchphrases of World War II is actually the name of a Chinese communist organisation.
Yeah. So not that old, then?
No, not that old at all.
At all?
No.
How extraordinary.
World War II.
Now, Chris, our challenger, it's a numbers game.
Can I try six more, please, Rachel?
You can, Chris. Back to a language we understand.
Thank you.
Language of numbers. Right, six more. Let's see what we've got. So we have 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, and 6. And the target to reach 690.
690. So, Chris, our challenger.
I have 690, but not written it down.
All right. And the champ?
I can't get any closer than 699.
Right. So that means that the challenger has now got to talk to Rachel.
OK, Rachel, I've got 7 times 8.
7 times 8 is 56.
Times that by 2.
Is 112.
Add on a 4 and take away 1.
Add 4 minus 1, 115.
And then times that by the 6.
And you have the 6 left over. Very nicely done.
Well, a pretty imperious lead there, 65 to 25, as we move into the tea time teaser, which is postured. And the clue, the peacock postured, it was most pleased. Welcome back, and the clue, the peacock postured, it was most pleased. And the answer, of course, is proudest, proudest. And so we move now to the letters game. And, Chris, off you go.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Chris. T.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
S.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
R.
And a vowel.
Another O.
And a consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, P.
Tick-tock. So, champ?
8.
8. And our challenger?
I'll try 8 as well.
8. Chris, the champ?
Portions.
Portions.
Mine's a bit riskier. Mine's snootier.
Snootier.
Yes.
Is that risky?
Not risky at all, Chris. None of your risky words have been risky. Well done.
Well done.
Yeah.
Gloria?
I don't think we're doing any better than that, are we?
No, we just have proteins for another 8.
Proteins. Snootier. We had Snooty Fox the other day. This is the even snootier fox. Very good. So, 73 to our challenger, 33 to the champ. And we move now to the challenger for a letters game. Off you go.
OK, can I start with a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Chris. D.
And a vowel?
E.
And a consonant?
R.
Another consonant?
S.
And a vowel?
A.
A consonant?
T.
A vowel?
Another E.
A consonant?
N.
And I will finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with A.
And we're away. So, Chris, our challenger, what have you got for us?
I just got a 6.
A 6. And the champ?
Yeah, 6 as well.
6. Chris, the challenger?
I've got Sander.
A Sander. And champ?
Teaser.
A teaser. Gloria? Susie?
Both fine.
We're both fine. And we have a 7 at Endears.
Endears.
Endears, yes. Rather nice word, isn't it?
It is a lovely word. And there's also standee, which is a passenger who has to stand on a moving vehicle.
Is that really a word, standee?
Yes. I hate to tell you, it's American again.
Yeah.
I have behind my dictionary, but yes.
Could you have a city as well, or setty?
A setty.
You sit on it anyway, don't you?
Yeah. All right. Good, 79 to 39. It's the champs crack at a letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Chris. R.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
You.
And a vowel.
You.
And a consonant.
P.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
N.
And a consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
And lastly, O.
Up and away. So, champ?
Seven.
Seven. And Chris?
Seven as well.
All right, champ?
Funny enough, portion.
Portion. Chris?
Same.
Same. All right, two portions here, please, if you wouldn't mind.
Funny enough, portion.
Three portions.
Yes, Susie? Turned up again. I had that too, and a couple of sixes, uproot and turnip.
Turnip.
But we prefer the portion.
We do like the portion.
A portion of turnips, if you wouldn't mind. So, 46 to 86. And, Chris, the challenger, it's a numbers game. Last numbers game.
OK, Rachel, I'll go one large this time, five small.
Playing it safe this time?
Yeah.
You don't need to. Sure, one large, five small?
No, I'll stay with one big.
One big, fair enough. Yeah. Not risking losing face. Thank you, Chris. So, for the last time, the five small ones are 9, 8, 1, 4, and 2, and the large one, 75. And the target, 529.
529. So, our challenger.
I got 529.
I'd expect nothing less. Chris?
Yes, I got 529.
All right, come on. Hear it from the challenger.
Yep. 9 minus 2.
9 minus 2, 7.
Times it by 75.
525.
And add on the 4.
Nice and easy. 529.
And the champ?
Yeah, except for 9 minus 2, I did 8 minus 1.
Yep. Same result.
Good. So, good result all around there. I think our challenger has an unassailable lead, 96 to 56, and so it is that we go into the last round, conundrum round, fingers on buzzers, please, for today's countdown conundrum. Pretty good. And?
Can we get 40 points for that? Bulldozer.
Bulldozer. Let's see what you've got. Well done. That's a final hurrah to your reign, anyway. A good one. But 66 to 96, our challenger snatches your crown and we say farewell to you, but you leave with a teapot and a goodie bag.
Wonderful.
And our best wishes. Been a good champ. It's been a busy old week, hasn't it? We've twisted and turned this week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yeah, I think that's the phrase, don't you?
It's a slalom. It's been a slalom. We'll see you tomorrow.
We will do.
Good opening game, yeah, well done. Thank you so much, Susie. As ever, Gloria, we shall see you tomorrow.
Pleasure.
More good stories.
At the door, knocking to get in.
Red carpet, we'll have it there again. How was it this morning?
It was good.
Excellent, the red carpet.
Very good.
We had it specially cleaned.
You had cleaned it beautifully overnight.
All right. Rachel, thank you very much indeed. Road rage. No more road rage.
OK, as long as you don't stay in front of me in your tractor.
Yeah.
Keep well away.
I don't take my tractor on the road. She's too precious, too precious. You're very precious at home. And we hope to see you again tomorrow. Same time, same place. Good afternoon.
It's going to be messy tonight. Father's doing time in daddy daycare coming our way tonight at 8 here on 4. After that, the midwives...